training today, and I knew that when I was upstairs, and I came down and I still ploughed through my first bit of food without filming it. Anyway, it was my porridge pudding, which was 50 grams of oats and 30 grams of whey. Can that count? Anyway, it's Tuesday. Good morning. Today was a good day. I had a very good training session again. They're all just great at the moment. Food's getting put to good use. It fires you up for training as well, because you're like, I've got to make this fucking count. This is going straight to my hamstrings. One bagel, 15 grams of jam. This is all pre-workout. My training's flying. Training is flying. Had a good day at work yesterday, worked from home, working from home today as well. Back in the office tomorrow and Thursday. And then working from home Friday. I'm feeling really good about everything, to be honest. Not been hungry this week so far. However, that is usually the case as I get from the weekend. The weekend I've had my off-plan meal and high calories. And I usually come into the new week feeling quite full. So it might get worse. I might be hungry again, but so far so good. Right, I'm sorry, what's going on at the moment? Why are these bananas so small? These are prep bananas. I want some off-season banana. The girl wanted an off-season banana. So I'm gonna have that before I go to the gym as well. They don't else do that with their bread knife. They must do. It's just crumbs, it's not wet, it's not tainted. Is that good logic or not? I don't know. Shoulders and chest today. Woo! I'll just make sure I actually use the scooper this time. That would really ruin my day again, wouldn't it? See, it is in there. Silly cow. Silly cow. Takes me so long to eat this. I don't know why. It's 6:30, so I should get to the gym before 7. Post-workout. I'll have them before I get back. I will make my other post-workout food. Ooh, ah.
Thank you. shoulders and chest done, cardio complete, feeling wicked. My training sessions are so good at the moment. I'm so, so happy with them. And today I was looking at myself and I've talked about this before about how hard it is during reverse and off season and entering into off season to kind of look at your shape changing and be happy. And it fluctuates. One day you're happy, one day you're not. One day you're like, oh, fucking hell, this is going too fast. The other day you're like, wow. It's very, very difficult. And trust me, no one is more annoyed about it than I am. So when you're watching these back, you're like, oh, just fucking settle on how you feel about yourself, Hannah. But it's very difficult too. And that's why I'm talking about it. Because other people will feel the same. And if you're watching these vlogs, thinking about competing, or you are competing, or you are in off-season, you are reversing, and you just want to know that someone else is feeling the same. Hello, I am. It's difficult. But today I looked at myself, and yesterday I looked at myself and was like, cool. Like, you look good. You look fabulous, darling. You look fabulous. And that's great. That is a huge milestone. For someone that's been through a body transformation and has lost so much weight, it can be an even tougher battle when calories go up, because, you know, it rings alarm bells, you get scared. But I think I'm managing pretty well so far. Body fat and physique is staying pretty consistent this week. Which sounds, it's a really stupid thing to say, but I'm looking consistent. There's not as much bloating. We'll see how things continue throughout the week. So that was training before work. I'm just about to get my post-workout crispy bars in, and then I'll go home and have my post-workout oats.
Just settling down to work. Good bowl of oats. There's 60 grams of oats in here and 30 grams of whey, and I'm having them hot just as a change from porridge pudding. Wow. I'll also get these down in a minute.
11's is time. Another bagel. We've got 10 grams of jam on that one and 10 grams of peanut butter on that one. Just before my next meeting, baking a cup of tea as well. Like, wadging together. Delicious. On a meeting. Making food. Eating 15 cashews and 140 grams of chicken, 150 grams of cooked weight pasta, 125 grams of pasta sauce, and 100 grams of mixed veg. I'm gonna mix that and wang it back in. Oh. Mm-hmm, the finished article. I mean, that's hot. Something that I was just going to, whilst I'm at home, show you. I've got a few of them. These are really good seasonings that I picked up from Aldi, and the reason why they're really good is because sea salt, black pepper, dried garlic, sweet paprika, dried onions, rosemary, chili, oregano, oregano, parsley, no sugar. You'll find that a lot of seasonings that you can just pick up off the shelf usually have high sugar content, or sugar is one of the like first five ingredients. Not these bad boys, just pick them up from Aldi. It's in this one: sea salt, dried onions, dried tomato, dried garlic, paprika, black pepper, coriander seeds, white pepper, chili flakes. No sugar. So I don't get too bothered about how much of these I use because of that, whereas had I picked up some of the seasonings that, you know, I might have previously used, really high sugar content and probably full of calories that you just do not need, and they taste great. Although I stay away from this one because I'm a pussy. So I not long had that pasta bowl with the chicken and the veg and the cashews. I'm fucking starving. This is what I mean. I can't work it out.
I can't work it out at all. I must have finished it about half an hour ago. 10 minutes. No, not even that. 20 minutes ago. Hunger signals aren't working properly, even 5 weeks post-show. It's just important to note that it will take a while for your body to work out what the fuck it's doing. Might have some rice cakes. My next meal is supposed to be another chicken pasta veggie bowl, but I kind of want to wait a little bit. I have just been sat down for a long time, so getting out for a walk after this next meeting is probably going to be a good option for me. I'll just go and do that, and that will hopefully help it tick over a little bit. But this is how it is some days. You just gotta get on with it and feel hungry. Wonder what my check-in will be like at the weekend. Because this week I pretty much maintained there wasn't a massive gain at all. It does make you wonder what's going on in there and how it all reflects in your check-in. I get excited to check in at the minute just to kind of see what's happening, because the whole process fascinates me really. I've got another meeting in 3 minutes. I'll go to that. Might go for a walk. We'll go for a walk after. Hope that the hunger subsides a little bit, and then come back and crack on a little bit more.
What did I say about not being hungry? Lol. Still hungry. It's absolutely fucking freezing. I don't know how girls made it to the worlds in a few extra weeks of prep, because I've put on some body fat now and I'm still frozen. That low body fat life is not for me anymore. Oh hell. Still feeling hungry. Could probably have another chicken meal, to be fair. Will I still feel hungry after that? The answer is probably yes. The gift that keeps on giving. Yeah.
Fancy another one. Going down a treat. 20 to 4, I'm doing well. I'm doing well. I've just been and popped loads of spots. So disgusting. But I am what I am. My skin is still doing a proper number on me at the moment. But it is what it is. We're just riding out. Riding. 5 rice cakes. These are the Aldi caramel ones. Now, you know, I'm a Home Bargs caramel gal. So let's try these for the first time. The content. Actually, decent. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. They are loads better than the Asda ones. The Asda ones are cack. Absolute cack. Don't waste your money. The Asda ones are garbage. They're nice. You're welcome, everyone.
Final meal of the day is, believe it or not, it's all under there. 180 grams of 5% mince. There's 180 grams of sweet potato. What I've done though is mixed a load of mustard and ketchup into the mince and added 30 grams of mozzarella on top. And it just tastes like a cheeseburger. And then I'm going to devour that afterwards. So yeah, this is deconstructed cheeseburger going in. And I'm just sat in the dark enjoying it. And that is my current full day of eating. It's not too dissimilar from the one that I did a little while ago. All my components generally stay the same. Although I am fancying some cereal. Everybody keeps posting post-workout cereal. And I'm like, I want to be a part of this club. It's 6 a.m. I've made it to the gym. I just wanted to give you a quick Dexter pup date. He's okay. He's back at home. He had surgery on Sunday and it's all gone really well. A foreign object was removed from him, but don't worry, my mum's kept it And we'll play a nice little game of what was removed from my family pet this weekend. This channel, I'm very sorry. But yeah, he's okay. He's just a little bit slower than usual, which is hard to believe, but he's okay. And we knew he would be. Bulldogs, obviously, a high risk. Dogs at the best of times, so getting him through an anaesthetic was a bit like, but he's all kinds of good and footloose and plastic free. It doesn't look like anything from a toy from what I've seen. I can't work it out myself. I kind of don't want to know either, because if it's something that like I've brought into the house or my dad has brought into the house, I think my dad would actually just burst into flames if he realised that he had done something to hurt that dog, because he fucking loves the dog. We all love that dog, but my dad is particularly emotional about the dog. So, kind of don't want to know, but we'll play that game. We'll play that game. Oh, change the record, Hannah. I can't. I'm still starving. I can't stop eating today. Don't get me wrong, only eating my things and not overeating. But fuck me, I've had to come out at like 12:30 so that I can just not eat. I can't stop it. Also, I forgot my mascara this morning, so I feel like a mole. I look like one as well. Also, forgot to take my pants into the gym with me. So got changed into my dungarees with no pants on and felt very weird walking into work with no pants on. Obviously, I went to the toilet and put my pants on. I can't even blame Prep Head on that anymore. Just forgot my pants. This is who I am.
The triad of high iron, high ferritin, high transferrin, I believe there may well be an underlying issue there. That's a genetic issue, okay?
Okay.
A genetic condition that I would say would be, potentially, is something called hemochromatosis. Now, that sounds like chromatosis is extremely, extremely well-researched. It's very, very apparent at the minute, especially in females, okay? And what that is a genetic condition in which your body doesn't know how to dispose of iron, okay? So it could well be down to it could lead to symptoms not limited to but inclusive of fatigue, lethargy, potential issue with digestion, bloating.
So are there any other kind of telltale signs of this that I might have experienced throughout my life?
Do you know, the issue with hemochromatosis is because the symptoms that you get from hemochromatosis are pretty much exacerbations of a tired life. Now, what I mean by that, sorry, that sounds really bad, but what I mean is a lot of people that exhibit the symptoms of hemochromatosis are just working really, really hard, but tired all the time, right? But the biggest telltale sign for me is when a patient comes to me or a client comes to me and they're saying, you know, even when I'm not on prep, I can walk into rooms not knowing what I walked into the room for. It's like what we call brain fog or brain lethargy. You know, there's this cognitive disconnect, per se, where you kind of, you know what you're doing, you set off to do something, and then you forget what you're there for.
Yep.
That coupled with the tiredness, In worst case scenario, things along the lines of itchy skin as well can be a telltale sign. But like I said, there's a vast spectrum of symptoms that you can go at. Like I said, with, unfortunately, linked to a lot of other issues as well.
Okay.
The way you determine whether it's hemochromatosis or not is by a genetic blood test. Okay.
Uh-huh.
So, a genetic blood test in which we will take the blood from you and have it screened for the three main mutagens of this, of three main codes, per se, of this genetic condition. Okay, if it is that you have this condition, it's such an easy condition to manage. Okay. It really, really is. And the way in which you manage it alleviates the symptoms straight away. Okay. Have you ever given blood? Have you ever done anything like that?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so you would probably have experienced when you gave blood, some of the symptoms that you face normally day to day would have alleviated. The main course of treatment will be for you, because we want to remove some of this iron from the circulation. We want to reduce this ferritin from circulation. And the only way you can really do it is by taking it out of the body.
Wow, okay.
Well, last night was quite the wild ride, wasn't it? So I've been reading up on hemochromatosis. It is really treatable. It's just mad to find out you've got a genetic disease just on a Wednesday night. As much as that was a bit of a shock, how good was the blood lab service? How informative was that? Like, I'm super impressed. With regards to my diagnosis, they've offered to do a kind of genetic screen just to kind of make sure that it is that, which costs around, I think it's like 125 quid or something. I'm just going to go to my GP and ask to be tested for it, because why would I spend 125 quid when I don't need to? And I'm going to go and get my bloods redone in around 8 to 12 weeks time. If I do get the diagnosis of the hemochromatosis, I will book in to give blood every 8 to 12 weeks. And that's how I'll manage it. I'll take any iron supplements out of my diet and revisit my supplements. I have been given some recommended supplements by the blood lab. I think they're a vitamin B complex, glutathione. I need to check that one. I need to look at that. One of them is the liver stack, and there's that glutathione. It's a strong product. They're the supplements that have been recommended to me by blood lab. It's Black Friday tomorrow. I'll probably have a look online and just see what I can pick up and get it that little bit cheaper as well, because, oh God, everything's so expensive. So yeah, don't know how I feel about it. It can have some bad side effects and stuff if it remains untreated, and can lead to like kidney failure, liver failure, heart failure, which is obviously isn't great. So need to start managing now that I know about it. Another thing that I needed to do, make sure any cereal that I have doesn't have any added iron. Don't have cereal anyway. And not to drink too much alcohol. Which I don't. But when we do drink, generally we don't drink during the week. It's not in my plan to drink during the week, so I don't drink during the week. And we've never been that kind of couple anyway. I'm just kind of taking that in, thinking about it. Looks like I'm about to become a super duper blood giver. I think I've already done, I have got an award for a certain amount of donations already, but I can't remember what it is. Well, about to get a whole load more. I do love giving blood. I also love giving blood at this time of year, because it's just a nice thing to do for a stranger. I know that you should think that way all year round, but I particularly think like that at this time of year, coming up to Christmas. And I used to do it every Christmas Eve. But my blood type is it ORH negative, where anyone can have it. So it's really important that I give blood anyway. So, fuck me. That's Wednesday into Thursday. So it's Thursday today. I'm a little bit apprehensive about how today's going to go, because it's my first, like, it's not my first rest day in a while, but it's my first rest day this week. I'm a bit worried about how my food's going to go down today, because the last couple of days I've been really, really hungry, and that's been on my training day food. It's just going to have to be a suck it and see, isn't it? I'll let you know how I feel.
It is Thursday night. I've just got in from work. It is 6:45. I'm just cooking up a shit ton of mince, because that is what I do. And I just wanted to share that I've passed my level 2 fitness instructor. So I am now qualified to do online coaching. I'm not going to roll it out for a little while. I want to make sure that I've got a few more tools in the chest and a bit more knowledge in the bank and stuff like that, and make sure that my training platform is exactly how I want it to be, and go through some of the basics of like just running my own business and stuff like that, like having an extra phone on my phone contract and the platform that I want to use, but even though I'm pretty sure I know which one I want to use, but how I set that up and how I do my training plans and how I work out my macros for clients and stuff. But I'm so excited. Bought the package in May. I started it at the mid-June after the NABBA British finals, and it's taken me this long to be able to have the time and the brain space to do it, and I'm so pleased with it. Good evening, it is Friday. It is about 6:10. I've just been and done my cardio. I didn't get it done this morning. I ran out of time and I ran out of time. How am I feeling? Okay, I've had a stomach upset today. I'm getting all kinds of bowel flare up, which is just my life. Always a fucking Friday. Always a Friday with a check-in on the Saturday. I don't really know what to do with this. It is what it is. It's fucking annoying, but it's just life. How am I feeling about my check-in tomorrow? Okay, other than the whole inflammation on the lower mid. But all in all, I'm holding well and I like the way I look. Look a bit thicker in the middle. That's okay. Starting to get a fatty on the legs. That's okay. Glutes feel like they're making some improvements. That's okay. And upper still looks pretty lean. That's okay. It's gonna do what it's gonna do. Weight is going on nicely though. I don't feel, on a good day where I'm not having any bloating or digestive issues, I'm looking at myself and I'm like, I'm holding this very, very well. And I'm liking where the fat distribution is going and everything like that. And I'm really hammering it. Have I had a few treats this week? A couple. No like meals as such or anything, but you know, those little caramel elves from Aldi. I've had a couple of those. I had a couple of miniature heroes today at work because someone was leaving and they were like, can you not have anything? And I looked at all the cakes and stuff and I was like, well, I'm not going to have a cake, but I will have a couple of chocolates and stuff. And it felt nice to kind of join in. I just still want to be really careful until I am safely out of this reverse, because my hunger hormones are so up and down still that I just still don't know what's going on. We're six weeks post show tomorrow and I'm still not normal. We're still not in a safe zone off season, I don't feel. So I am still being very careful. I am still exercising some restriction in there because I just, for myself, have to smash this as hard as I can. But I have had a couple of little treats here and there. Andy bought me some flips from America. I had a couple of those on Monday night. Like, just little bits. Probably 100 calories, if that, a day. Not even every day. Just a few days this week, and it felt nice. So that's how I'm feeling about my check-in tomorrow. Why am I back in Morrison's car park, I hear you ask? Well, because I have it on good authority from my friend Vic, who runs Cookie Box Co, that this is where I will find the Biscoff cream bars. When I tell you that I thought they were just exclusive to Co-op, and I've been in every single Co-op that I have driven past, walked past, anything, I've been trying to find this chocolate and I haven't found any yet. None. And she's only just, and I'm questioning our friendship here because she's only just told me that that's where she gets it from. I used to shop at Morrison's all the time, and then I switched to Lidl and Aldi at the end of prep because I was like, why the fuck am I spending extra money on the same thing? And I've been shopping at Aldi and Lidl since, and who knew? This is where I find Biscoff cream, so we're going to go and try and find it.
I just come downstairs to do my check-in and just shit myself because I thought we had a poltergeist. Andy, what actually happened?
I opened my cupboards to help get rid of some, no, but we've got visible damage.
I genuinely just shit myself and screamed to get him down here because I thought we had a poltergeist. It's all fine.
Eating my post-workout oats before I go into Aldi. I've just filmed a little bit of a ab session that I've started putting in. The plan is to just work really hard and see what I look like the next time I get on stage, but there's a possibility that the next time I get on stage I will want to push up to athletic, and for athletic I need abs. So we've chucked in an ab session on a Saturday. Oh my god, they're still so hot. This thing is so good. And I just wanted to jump on and talk about my check-in this morning. I'm so happy with it. So happy with it. I've put on another just under a kilo, I think. Maybe less. I'm buzzing. I think I look really good. It sounds really weird to talk about yourself like that, but why can't you? Very, very happy with how I look today. Very, very happy with how I look in that check-in. Very happy with how I look during my ab workout today. Very happy indeed. Gonna go into Aldi now and pick up some bits for a roast that I'm gonna cook for my family tomorrow. Gonna have an off-plan meal tonight. Feeling fajitas. So we're gonna make fajitas. So I'm just gonna go and do that. And then for the rest of the day, I think we're gonna go into town, go for a walk, get some bits done and chill out a little bit. I'm gonna do a little bit of work for my coaching qualification. I definitely don't need the baby spoon anymore because my food's so high, but it's the only thing that gets right to the bottom of here, so allow it. When I get some feedback from coach, I'll let you know what she says and what the plan is. Morning is Sunday, so oh my life, look at them tired eyes. I'm not actually that tired. Started waking up at 6:30 on a weekend, regardless of whether I'm doing anything or not, because apparently that's what my body wants to do nowadays, so fine, whatever. Just got to the gym, gonna get my 20 minutes cardio in, and then I've just got steps to get for the rest of the day because it's rest day. Feedback on my check-in yesterday, Jenna is so happy, and so am I. Everything's gonna stay the same. Everything's gonna stay the same. We've found a really good like baseline high calorie for me. So food won't change, steps won't change, cardio won't change. We're just gonna see how I get on and how my weight climbs. She has said, you know, if there's anything that I want during the week, like little treats like I've done this week, like with the couple of the elves and stuff from Aldi and what will probably become my advent calendar and stuff like that, I can just have and I can add in and just, you know, keep them small and keep them reasonable, but I can have those and we'll just see how I get on. So I'm not eating like a twat and not milking it, but I can still have a little bit of what I want. That is the approach that we're going to go for at the moment because it's working. And I don't feel like I'm missing out too much at all. I'm going to keep it neat and tidy. And so far, that's how I'm looking. I'm looking neat and tidy. But it's early days. It's early days. It might be that, you know, it's we do need to push up. As and when, and we'll just keep an eye on everything. My check-ins are going to get a little bit more in detail now as we go into off season. I feel like we're no longer reversing, we are off season. Check-ins will be a bit more detailed about my well-being and how I'm finding the gym and everything else that goes with it, whereas my check-ins at the moment have been very, I'm fucking starving, my poops did this, my energy levels are this. They're focused on performance, digestion, sleep and mood and things like that. But this will be a lot more in depth now, and I will go into a bit more detail with it just so that we've got a bit more data to analyse. Gonna get this cardio done, get my steps in and cook a roast for the family and find out what was removed from my dog. Just a typical family day in my life. So the other day when I got excited about the Biscoff chocolate, I picked up the Biscoff crumb. Now, we did try it. It is amazing. But it wasn't what I was after. I was after this one. When I tell you it's probably the best chocolate bar, oh, do I say ever? Because I know that's Andy will shout. Bold claim, but what do you say? It is, isn't it?
If you like Biscoff, it's your one.
It's just the tits. The Biscoff crumb has got the chunks in it. They're both just as, they're both really, really sick. But that has got creamy biscuits in. But I still think the Biscoff cream has got like a crunch to it, hasn't it? Just yeah. Run to Morrison's.
Yeah, it's just got crunchy biscuit bits in it.
Just run to Morrison's. Do yourself a favour. If you're going into off season, you need this. Per 15 grams is 84 calories in the Biscoff cream, and then obviously I bought two of each, and there's 80 calories in the crumb one. Negligible. Lazy Sunday mode activated. I've just made my cauliflower cheese to take to my mother's. What else? Honey's getting ready. We're just gonna make our way up there in about half an hour. I was gonna talk about Black Friday sales actually. I didn't find them that inspiring this year, and I'm trying to not buy things. My prepped and packed bag never turned up, and I've challenged them about a refund, and it's taken this long to get it. So whilst Black Friday was on, I picked up the Alpha design meal bag, which I thought was like radically priced, but it was in the Black Friday sales, and because I was getting this refund, it's exactly the same price.
So I've bought that. That's gonna be arriving. Whilst the Black Friday sale was on Insta, I picked up some of the supplements that I was recommended following my diagnosis of hemochromatosis. We'll find out a little bit more about that in the weeks to come, I'm sure, but I've picked up some supplements for that and I'll show you them when they arrive. And I picked up a new posing bikini. So I've gone to Miss Bikini Fitness for my posing bikini because there's nothing wrong with Sammy's bikinis at all. All of Sue's bikinis attach here for figure suits, which is really, really helpful. So picked up one of those and that is arriving probably within the week. So that's exciting. But yeah, that's all I really found in the Black Friday sales. Everything else was a bit garbage. There wasn't even anything for the house that we were that excited about, was there?
No, not really.
I got excited about Nespresso machines, but was still told I have to wait until after Christmas. There you go. That's what came out of Dexter. Any guesses? You can post it in the comments, because we're still not sure. But he's fine.